Hi, I am Lynn Kuriakos from Department of BCA, Nirmala College, Moottipuzha. In this session, I will be explaining the topic instruction cycle, which is one of the important topic of computer architecture. So before going into the topic, let me first explain some basic concepts. All of you have heard about computer programs. We write several programs using different programming languages like C, C++, Java, Python, etc. Now, what is a program? A program can be defined as a set of instructions. Where do we store these instructions or programs? These instructions are stored in the memory unit of a computer. The basic functional units of a computer consist of input-output unit, memory unit, and central processing unit. Input-output unit is the part through which the user interacts with the system. Same way, all the programs and data are stored in the memory unit. Then, the processing of these instructions are done in the central processing unit. Next, let's see the general format of a central processing unit. CPU consists of arithmetic and logic unit or ALU. It is the place where all the arithmetic and logical operations are being done. Next, we have a control unit. Control unit controls the overall operation of a computer. Or, in other words, we can say that the control unit is the central nervous system of a computer. In addition to these two units, central processing units contains several registers. These registers are used for fast access of information. There are some special purpose registers. One of them is program counter or PC. Program counter contains the address of the next instruction. Then another special purpose register is instruction register or IR. IR is used to store the current instruction. Sorry, in addition to these two registers, there are two other special purpose registers. One is MAR, that is memory address register, and MDR, memory data register. These two registers are always in direct contact with the memory unit. So this MAR contains the address of the location from which we need to fetch an information. Same way, MDR is used to store the data which we are reading from the memory or the data which we have to write into the memory. Then, other than this, there are some general purpose registers which are used to store intermediate data, or sometimes they are used to store the result of an operation. So nowadays, the commonly used general purpose register is accumulator, or it's denoted by AC. Now we'll come to instruction cycle. So we already know what an instruction is, and we know that the instruction is stored in the memory unit of a computer. Instruction cycle means the sequence of steps through which each instruction has to go through in order to process it. Mainly, instruction cycle consists of three steps. So the first is fetching, second is decoding, and the third is executing. Or in other words, we can say that instruction cycle is also known as fetch, decode, execute cycle. Now, let's see the first step, that is fetching. We know that the instruction is already stored in the memory. That instruction should be accessed into the CPU. That is done in the fetching process. So, fetching process involves accessing the information or accessing the instruction which is stored in the memory. Then, the fetching process involves three operations. The first one is the information stored in the program counter is transferred into memory address register. So, we have seen that program counter contains the address of the next instruction. That address is transferred to memory address register. Then, from that particular address, we fetch the current instruction and it is then transferred to instruction register. So, these two transfer operation is done in the fetching process. Now, the current instruction to be executed is brought into the instruction register contained in the CPU. Other than this, one more operation takes place here, that is, the program counter is incremented by 1, which means the program counter is getting ready for the next instruction. Then, next is the decoding phase. What happens in the decoding phase? The instruction is already brought to the instruction register. We need to analyze what type of instruction is this, or we need to understand the meaning of this instruction. That is being done in the decoding phase of the instruction cycle. So, for that, we need to understand the format of an instruction. Each instruction consists of 3 parts. The first 12 bits contains the address of the data. The next 3 bits contains the opcode. Opcode stands for operation code. It is a set of 3 bits which denote which operation is to be performed. Then the last bit is a mode bit. This mode bit and the opcode bits together decide what type of instruction or is it, or what type of operation is to be performed. So, once the decoding is done, we are ready to execute the instruction. Depending upon the type of instruction, the particular or the required circuit is being executed. Now, next let's see a flowchart of the decoding process. The opcode bits are transferred to a decoder, and the output of the decoder is used to analyze the type of instructions. So, in this flowchart, we can see the D7 output. When the D7 output is 0, we can determine that it is a memory reference instruction. That is, the same way, if the D7 output is 1, we can decide that it is a register reference or input output reference instruction. So, when the opcode is 111, we specify that it is a register reference or input output instruction. For all other combinations of opcode, we can determine that it is a memory reference instruction. Next, we come to the mode operator I. So, whenever the mode operator is 1, we determine that it is an input output operation. Similarly, when the mode operator is 0, we can say that it is a register reference instruction. Same way, memory reference instructions are also of 2 types, direct address instruction and indirect address instruction. Now, direct address instruction contains, that is the memory address, memory location contains the operand itself. Whereas, in indirect address instruction, the address of the or the memory location contains the address of the data. So, when the mode input I is 1, we say that it is an indirect instruction. Similarly, when the mode input is bit is 0, we say that it is a direct address instruction. Now, we have determined the type of instructions. Now, these instructions will get executed depending on its type. So, now we have reached the end of our session. That's all with instruction cycle. Thank you.